Now let us see what is the cause of deviation from ideal behavior. Okay, real gases, they obey ideal gas equation when at low pressure and high temperature only. Low pressure and high temperature only. Okay, at high pressure and low temperature, just the opposite. The following two assumptions of kinetic theory, they are not holding good. If the pressure was high and temperature low, whatever kinetic theory of gases have assumed, those assumptions are not holding good. They are not okay. Now what are they? One postulate says volume occupied by the gas is negligible in comparison with total volume of the gas. Why so? Because the molecules are highly microscopic in nature. They have very, very small size. So even if you put all the molecules together, the volume occupied by the molecules will be negligible in comparison with the total volume of the container. Okay, that's why he said that volume occupied by the gas is negligible in comparison with total volume. Okay, then another postulate is the force of attraction or repulsion between the gas molecules is negligible. This is one other assumption. Okay, there is no force of attraction. That is why the gases are moving continuously. If they are getting attracted towards each other, then it will get liquefied, is it not? So there is no force of attraction. Whatever volume is given to a gas, it will occupy the complete volume. Okay, if you give it 1 liter, it will occupy 1 liter. If you give 20 liters, it will occupy 20 liters. Is that clear? So whatever space is provided, the molecules will start moving in that space. Now the above two are true when only at low pressure and high temperature. At high temperature, the molecules have swift movement, and at low pressure, they are free to move. Is that clear? So these two assumptions, they are holding good only at low pressure and high temperature. Now, if the conditions were reversed, that means high pressure and low temperature, agar manoge, then the force of attraction may not be negligible. At high pressure, the molecules will come closer to each other, is it not? That means there is possibility of getting compressed. So you will say force of attraction may not be negligible. Same way, volume occupied is so small that volume cannot be assumed negligible. Right? Supposing if you are considering 10 ml of volume is occupied by all the molecules and the container volume is 1 liter. So 10 ml in 1 liter, it cannot be neglected. If it is 0.1 ml in 1 liter or 10 liter, then it can be neglected. But then if you consider this way, you cannot neglect the volume. Okay. So hence, ideal gas equation, because of all these behavior, this ideal gas equation had to be modified. Who modified it? J.D. van der Waals. He was the one who modified. So he considered the above two points and he modified the equation as P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT. This is for 1 mole of a gas. If you want to consider for n moles of a gas, then the equation goes like this. P plus A n square by V square into V minus NB is equal to nRT. Now what is A and B here? They are called as van der Waals constant. Okay. And this A depends upon intermolecular forces and B depends upon the size of molecules. Okay. So that we will discuss in the next lecture.